Okay, well, we'll keep alternating back and forth. Getting out of a state of stasis. All right, here we go. Let's get this guy all centered. All right, stat tests. Prop Z, 0.000745. Whoops. Okay, it changes it to, one too few zeros. Oh, no, I don't, because it has to move one more time. Good. We have 402 deaths. How many cars on the road that year?
509,000.
590,000. We're going for a greater than, yes? We're going to show the Gainesville Sun is right. Should we draw? I think draw's better. Let's draw the curve.
It's a lot different this time.
Okay. You guys getting this? What's that telling you?
That 96% of the time.
Okay, so look at where I drew this curve up here, yes? This is the old 1999 motorcycle death rate, right here, yes? This is where the Gainesville Sun wants me to believe my new data is. Wants me to believe it's here, right? Where is it actually?
No.
It's over here. The new motorcycle death rate is far, far less than what it was before. Say that again.
Is that because there's less people?
It's because, what?
Less population. I guess I worded that wrong. So there's.
I know what you're saying. I think I know what you're saying, Tyler.
99, the population in Florida.
Was less.
Less.
Right, which means it's grown in 10 years.
Yeah.
So arguably, if the population of Florida has grown in 10 years, what other smaller subpopulation probably has grown too?
Motorcyclists.
Fair? So I'm not saying that 402 people dying on motorcycles is anything other than sad, 402 times over. But what I'm saying is, yes, I'm assuming 402 was the largest number of deaths they've ever had on motorcycles in any recorded year. But I would not be surprised if in 2009 there were also record numbers of motorcycles registered on the road. Which means the ratio of 402 to the number of motorcycles on the road as a ratio is actually dropped below. And that's, I think, what is playing out in the actual curve here. Yeah? Look at that p-value. It's 96%. Right? I mean, that's a huge p-value. It's almost 100%. As a matter of fact, it's so big. Look at this little, this isn't a p-value because we didn't test this, but what's that guy right there? Is that like 3.5%? As a matter of fact, I don't think we've not only disproven this and this, I think we've proven that, haven't we? If we were to switch the hypotheses, we've actually shown that it's dropped over time. It's 3%. If we just switch the sign to less than, we actually proved that, didn't we? But we weren't setting out to do that. We were setting out to support the Gainesville Sun. Can we do so? Of course not! So it
does not
appear that
motorcycle deaths have increased.
Can we say motorcycle death rate? Is that okay? The deaths themselves may have increased, right, Elizabeth? But the death rate sure as hell hasn't. Looks like it's gone down. Could we be wrong? Of course, always. How could we be wrong this time?
False negative.
This is definitely a false negative, right?
But we took our population from
9. Oh, you're thinking non-sampling error, Elizabeth. Thank you. I don't mean non-sampling error. Good for you. I'm thinking as a statistical result. That result could be an outlier. Now, realize how hard it is to believe it's an outlier for a false negative. A false negative would imply that the motorcycle death rate actually has gone up and we missed it, correct? Gone up would mean, this is pointed the wrong way, let me point this over here. Gone up, let's wait, Brandon up too, let me get up. Gone up means that the death rate was here and now it's somewhere over there, correct? Which means it's somewhere like here. How likely is it on that curve to the right of this one that we landed way the hell down here? That's getting really hard to believe, isn't it, friends? It's hard to believe if it's actually over here that we landed way past this average all the way over here. Wouldn't it be easier to believe that this curve should be there? It's all which one is easiest to believe. It's hard to believe the null because we're too far to the left. It's even harder to believe this red curve is further right because we're so far to the left. It's easier to believe we're here, which means that we cannot support the Gainesville Suns' claim. We've actually supported exactly the opposite of their claim. Chris, go!
Given that we don't know the amount of motorcycles on the road at the time of...
In 1999, correct.
Can we say that the amount of deaths have increased? I mean, maybe there were less...
We can say the amount. That's why we're not testing an average, we're testing a rate. No, Chris, what you're saying is good. This is why I said to Elizabeth as well, we haven't tested that claim, that the number of deaths has increased. But the reason I bring this up is I always get nervous talking about a pure number when a percentage is a better argument. Here's why, right? Look at... Okay, so recently, a student sent me an exasperated email saying, Rule, you've ruined me. I mean, you guys have all said this too. I can't read the news anymore without thinking twice of everything they say. It says 25% of women are impacted by breast cancer. And then the first thing he wants to know is, what does impacted mean? And then we got this discussion back and forth once I saw him in person. I said, and he's like, yeah, my mother's sister, my aunt, and my neighbor has breast cancer, and this person has breast cancer, this person. Totally get that, right? But the problem with that is, those are the ones you're noticing. They have the condition of the experiment, affected or have breast cancer. What it's ignoring is all the other ones that don't have breast cancer, so we can't form a ratio of how big too big is. So when they say 402 people got killed in motorcycle-related deaths, I'm not saying that's anything except the tragedy 402 times over. But if the year before there were 200 deaths, I'm going to exaggerate the difference here. If the year before there were 200 deaths, but there were fewer than half the bikers that year as well, that means the rate was actually higher the year before. It becomes a matter of division, right?
Yeah.
Right? And think of it, if you want to use the numbers simpler, maybe 10 people died this year and 5 people died last year. But if there were 100 bikers this year and 20 bikers last year, the rate's actually gone down. Does that make sense? I mean, I think that's the best way of looking at this data. I'd like to have the actual numbers, obviously, but in lieu, I think the numbers we have are the best ones to use. Chris, does that make sense?
Yeah.
Do you buy it?
I guess so.
I'm not trying to twist your arm. I'm just trying to give you my opinion as to why I like looking at it this way. Is that fair?
Yeah, well, I mean, it's the only way you can base it.
I think so, yeah. I think so, because it is purely discrete data. Did you die or did you not die? I mean, trivialize this or marginalize this. But it's not really a measure. It's a number of deaths. And since it's a number of deaths, we kind of have, what would you average? I guess that's the idea, is what would you average it with? You have 402, right? It's not like you have repeated measures of something that you then average to get a central value. You've got one discrete value. The only thing you really do with that is divide it by the total to get a percentage. That's, in my opinion, the best thing to do. Is that believable?
Yeah.
I do want to get into on Monday or Tuesday.
I won't
see you. Wait, Tuesday?
Thursday.
I won't see you until Thursday. Yes, don't come Tuesday. Thank you to all the veterans. Veterans Day. Yes? I almost forgot about that. Thank you for saying that. Oh, speaking of non-related stuff that I forgot to tell you on Tuesday as well, I forgot to mention, some of you know this already, the exam you guys submitted and kicked ass on last week, there is a rainy day exam coupon for that. I forgot to mention that. If you've had me before, you know this. You can do 5 points of correction on that exam and resubmit before the end of the term. So if you go to the Rainy Day Coupons link on the schedule page, there's one for a project. If anybody's sitting here, oh, if you don't mind, just go ahead and do a little Vanna. Thank you very much. Very nice, little Vanna. Very nice. There's a Rainy Day Project coupon, which maybe somebody's using today, which they walked in and go, oh shit, there was a project due today. So that buys you 24 hours. But the exam coupon allows you to pick up 5 points that you lost on your exam, if you lost 5 points, up to 5 points. I forgot to mention that on Tuesday. There's also a quiz correction, too. We can deal with that one.
And if you don't use the project quiz one, you get the 5 points.
That's worth 5 points, yes, sir. The exam and the quiz are not worth anything unless you use them. But yes, the project coupon, if you don't use it, is still worth 5. Absolutely. I didn't change that.
Just email you for the quiz one?
Email.
If we want to use our quiz coupon.
Oh, no, read the actual coupon. It's all about printing.
Okay.
It's all printing out and stapling coupons. I'm kind of old school like that. I like that. Old school coupons. So, cut out. Cool. It's all on there. It's all the checks. Here's the check boxes. Good? Fair-ish. Getting there. I got one more for us to do. Then we'll kick you guys out of here. Let's come over here. And I like ending with this one because we usually have a pretty small sample size, although a lot of